Okay, in this video we're going to be working on this page. So, stay tuned! What I'm going to be working on this page is a girl with a pineapple in a summer background. At least that's the direction I'm taking. You know what happens once you start a page? Things start going in different directions. You will also notice some kind of funky shades because I don't have my usual setup. But sometimes you do things with what you have, right? What I'm thinking is that she's holding it, so I put the pineapple in an angle. I'm going to move the camera so you can see what I'm doing. I'm not sure if it shows, but I'm going to start working on her arm over here. Well, I got myself in a pickle here. I run out of space, so I'm going to make her arm a lot smaller, even if it isn't a natural size, but it's going to be cute at the end. I think I'm going to have her with a braid over here. I just will mark slightly what I will follow later as a pattern, which is going to be some kind of little diamond shapes. And what I'm going to be using is these little pages of some old book for her dress. But I will be back in a second when I have all my stuff ready. We're going to start with her dress. This is the first wash that is going to give me a lot of covering of little nooks and crannies without stealing the shapes of other things like the pineapple leaves This is watery, so if I don't cover one thing or the other, it still will be showing some color. And then I will come back and do something more opaque that will give us more definition. So while this is drying, I will work a little bit with my charcoal pencil just to do the hair. And I'm thinking I might as well go with the pineapple. With my darkest green, which happens to be a sap green, I will be working on the leaves, define some lines, and sap and water, so it is more like a glaze than an actual color. I'm going to go same thing as the charcoal to make the charcoal stain without moving much and give some color to the leaves. And I'm seriously hoping you can see this, because where I am right now I cannot see my screen. I'm going to give the pineapple a little bit of green as well. More than anything to settle the black. With a very watered down black, I will do the hair. I want to wait for the lighter green until I have that other green settled so I don't smear them together. I'm going to move the camera over here so you see so far what's been going on from another angle. I will be working in her skin. I'm going to be with layers in something that I don't like much, which is wet on wet, because usually that makes me just go to places that are a bit messier than what I really care for. But at the same time, sometimes awesome things happen. Kitty! Okay, once we have that brown settled in there, I'm going with a lighter pink with a lot of water. And make it in a way that the brown that we set first is going to be as a shadow in the places where, like in this case, the sunlight would be over here, so my shadows would be over here. I'm going to do the same with the brown color over here, going under the chin and make it a little bit of a shade. I will do the same on any areas that are sunken in the face, to call it one way. And then I'm coming back with my lighter color. In water, not too much, because this paper might not be too absorbent. Unless that you know that your paper is very absorbent, don't get too carried away with the water. Okay, I had a little bit of charcoal. I'm just going to drag it to the side and get more of my pink. With more water, a little bit of pink, and a little bit of the brown, I will go back again in some areas. Just to define. Maybe a little bit more softer. Keep a napkin handy so you can do some cleaning of your brush if needed. Now, with a little smaller brush, which I don't have handy, of course, we will bring our white into the picture to highlight. And don't get too afraid don't get afraid at all. If you make a mess on one corner or another, you just add more paint. If one eye is going up and the other one is going down, just check what's going on and add more paint to whatever you need. And then you shadow again, and then you highlight again, and so you just do this kind of a dance where you go to the front, to the back, to the front, to the back. At one point, things will start looking the way you want. I think I'm going to let this dry a little bit more. And then I will come back with, this is a green for the leaves. And my intention is to give highlights and body to the leaves. So I will be using the green with white, and then without, and then maybe some yellow. We're going to start with our ochre, and then we're going to be adding some different yellows from the darkest to the lightest. So for this first layer of the ochre, I'm going to be adding a little water just to give it a bit of transparency. hope you enjoy the process, and I might add a couple of little details later on once it's dry and if I feel like it needs something else, but for now I think she's ready. Let me know if you like it.